Welcome back, Tigers. This video will show you how to report on emails that are sent via mass email, via a list email, or via a user sending an email using an HTML email template. We will be reporting on the emails that we sent in the video called Salesforce Mass Email versus List Email. Let's hop over to Salesforce and check out how to set up these reports. All right, we're first going to learn how to report on the email status of an email that an individual user sends. So we're going to go to the Reports tab and we're going to click New Report. And there is a report type called HTML Email Status. So you need to make sure you're looking for all over here. And this is the report type that we want. So we'll click Start Report there. And I'm going to make this show for all time. And then we can add our columns in. If you know a faster way to do this, let me know in the comments below. All right. And then I'm going to click Save and Run. And then here's all of the emails that have been sent out by me. Now, caveat with this report is this report only works for the logged in user. You can only see the emails that were sent by you. Your manager cannot look at this report and see any emails that were sent by you. You cannot, as an admin, look at a report that shows all of the emails and their whether or not they were opened, when they were opened from a report like this. This is just a limitation within the email tracking capabilities within Salesforce. If you want something more robust, you'll have to use a marketing automation tool. So just be aware that this is only going to work if you are the person sending the email, if you sent an email that is an HTML email template, and this does not work for Einstein Activity Capture users. So if you are using Einstein Activity Capture to sync your emails, nothing's going to come in here, even if you sent the email through Salesforce. So that's something that we've run into and seen in action. Now let's look at how to report on our mass emails. So we're going to go to our Reports tab again. We will click New Report, and then we're going to look for Activities. And then we're going to choose either activities with contacts or activities with leads. I'm going to choose activities with contacts because I know I have more records there. And then we want this to show open and completed. I'm going to say all time here. And then this needs to be filtered for the subject line. Is going to start with mass email. Okay, and we have one record coming in, which is correct because this is the mass email that we sent in the previous video. So I'm just going to put the date in here. There's not much information to share here. So we will save and run this. This will be our mass email report. And if we click the subject line of this record, we can see that there's not really any other fields that we could bring into our report. So this is about all you're going to get when you're reporting on your mass emails. Now let's check out our list emails. So these are a little bit better because you can get a lot more information about your last email, like how many people got the email and that sort of thing. So we're going to create a new custom report type here. And this is going to be the object is list emails. And we're going to call this list emails with recipients. We'll store this in activities. And then we'll choose list email sent results and click save. Okay, so now we'll come back to our reports tab. We'll click new report. And we're going to choose that report type. So I have one list email that I sent, which is correct. And then I'm going to add in some columns here. Okay, looks like when you put the activity field in here, your results go away, which is not awesome. Okay. I'm gonna put these in order. And then let's just pop this open to see what other fields we have to choose from. So these fields right here, name is tracked and status. These are the fields related to the list email themselves. And then the individual emails and whether or not it was sent or bounced or whatever it was are over here. So I can drop reason in there. Okay, well, we will save and run this. This will be our list email report. And we can see that one list email sent, and then you'll see a row for each email that your list email was sent to. And you can see whether or not it was sent or bounced. You won't see unsubscribed because there's no automated way in Salesforce to manage your unsubscribes. So keep that in mind. Now, I'm not sure what this reason field is here. I looked in the API documentation over here and we don't see a reason field listed, and there's also a lot of other fields that you'll see on here. So if we hop down to the R's, we can't see the reason. All the other fields that you're seeing are from the account engagement product that Salesforce has. So don't get confused if you check out the API documentation and wonder why you can't see all those fields like total opted out and all that other good stuff. This is the basic information that you're going to get when you're reporting on list emails. Now, if you sent a list email to a campaign, you are able to bring in the campaign information into your report. So we can add the campaign name here, and then we can see it and group it by that campaign if we wanted to. So if you were sending multiple list emails to a single campaign, you could report on that. If you wanted to then pull some of those fields into your report, on the campaign object, you can do that as well. So not sure if you guys are aware of this little feature over here, but you can add fields related via lookup. So if I click that, I can see that campaign is a choice here. And then if I wanted to add additional columns to my report to report on campaigns further, I could. So I'll check on those boxes. What it does is it drops all these fields and I can create a new section called campaign fields. I can drag those down to this section down here, hit save, and then come back to my report. And I should be able to pull in those fields for my campaigns after I refresh. So there's my campaign fields. So that's a cool little feature that you can do with any report type, custom report type that you create. You can pull over fields for a related object onto your report. All right, so those are the three ways that you can report on your email activity out of Salesforce when you're using mass emails, list emails, or an HTML email template. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blu Tiger Academy so you don't miss the next video we are working on that will show you how to do advanced reporting on leads and contacts. You will learn how to easily find contacts who have an open opportunity or who have not been followed up with in a certain time frame. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you would like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.